Let me tell you the story of how I went from this to this. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And I love to play with makeup. Yeah, that's it. I love drugstore, I love indie, as long as it's cruelty free, I'm happy. And I'm also kind of, yeah, some people have called me weird. I don't know why though. But yeah, I do know that I have a sarcastic sense of humor, so I live in a very noisy neighborhood. So if you like that, don't forget to hit the subscribe button because I upload regularly. Yes. So today, as you heard in the intro, I will tell the tale of how this happened, basically. And I'm also going to play with some new stuff, I think. And they are doing something to the street, making blue lines because of the parking zones. That's it. Yeah, I got my order in from AOA Studio, and of course I got my order in from AOA Studio on the same day that I went to Alkmaar with my bestie, because Primark had my favorite falsies again, and I also ordered a bunch of falsies from AOA Studio. So I have a bunch of falsies from AOA Studio. I also have two primers. I have a face primer and I have an eye primer pot. I have heard great things about this face primer, so I'm actually very curious. And this is the eyeshadow primer from Amuse pot thingamajingy. That I thought maybe is, I don't know, a dupe for the MAC Paint Pot. It's very, very small, which I kind of like because the MAC Paint Pot is pretty big. Yes, it takes ages to get through that. And that is what I have new. Yeah, then the falsies I have new. I don't really know what kind of eyeshadow palette I want to use. So, ghosties. Weird stuff is happening, and not just with my hair. So what I am going to do is prime the face first. Yes, prime the face with the primer because I'm very curious. And then, oh, it's very liquidy. I have already put what's it called again? I want to say glue, but that's not it. Soap. Wow, in my brows, and let it set a little bit. This feels nice. It feels like a moisturizer. Okay, that's nice. Okay, so let this kind of sink in for just a little bit. I'm also going to do the rest of the base off camera, as not to make the video too long. So I can also kind of maybe concentrate a little bit more on the tail of the hair, or lack thereof. So yeah. Sounds very, very dramatic. I'm also dramatic, by the way. Let me do my brows. I have changed my mind, yes. As per usual.
Oh no, I need a pencil. Do I have one here? No, that's MUA.
Let me grab a new pencil. That's better. Now I don't feel like I have no eyebrows. That was actually the first thing that my son thought when he saw me. I said, stuff happened, and he said, did you shave your eyebrows? I said, no. Maybe I need to clarify, this stuff kinda is not weird in my house. Mainly me going from long hair to short hair, from blonde to dark, from black to red, and everything in between, you know? It's not really weird. I have had this kind of hairstyle for, I think, almost 4 years maybe now, and it is the best thing that I ever did. I have mentioned it before, so yeah. However, I wanted to go silver again, and I did. I went silver again, and it was glorious for 2 weeks. Yes, I'm building suspense. I'm also kind of give you a little bit of a background story. I like to go silver from time to time, and I do it myself, and it always goes very, very well. Just saying. And then when I don't feel like being silver anymore, I just shave my hair and let it grow back, you know? That's kind of a little bit of the history leading up to, maybe you can kind of tell where this is going. I'm going to tell it anyway. However, first I'm going to draw the eyeshadow palette because I have no idea what I want to play with today. So I thought, let me kind of use my wheel of what and draw. Yes? Okay. And draw. Let me also see if I can do the screen recording thingy again. That would be fun. Screen recording? Okay, it's screen recording now. So now I'm going to go to my social. Yes, then to Wheel of What. And I'm going to spin in 3, 2, 1, now. Ooh, well, okay, that is nice. The VE Fox palette. So let me grab her. And she's here, the Vixen. So I'm going to play with the Vixen today, which is, yeah, kind of almost a karma thingy because I kind of wanted to look like a silver Vixen. Yes, I look like Auntie Fester, but that's neither here nor there. So I know that the fallout on this palette isn't too bad, so let me whack on a little bit of foundation. And the foundation I'm going to wear is the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage in the shade Sand Beige, so I can kind of see how it layers on top of the primer. And basically because I want to wear it today. So yeah, basically I thought, you know what, this summer, past summer, I haven't been silver. I have actually been bald quite often because I found it pleasant to shave my head completely bald. I thought it was nice. And it was, I don't know, it was nice and cool because the summer was very, very warm. Oh, I love this foundation so much. What are you doing? I don't know. So I thought, you know what, some of you asked if I was growing, oh, this foundation is so pretty, if I was growing my hair out, and I kind of was a little bit. It was basically twofold. I did not feel like shaving it, and I kind of wanted it a little bit longer for when I went silver again, because that was a little bit of the plan as well. Oh, when the color of this foundation is good, it is just so pretty. And it goes on top of this primer very, very prettily. Is that a good English? I don't know. And it is still one of my favorite foundations, this. I do have to say, though, that if I have a shade that is maybe a little bit too dark or too light from this foundation, it is not looking so good. So I need to make sure that the shade is good. This one is maybe a little bit, I don't know, not yellow enough. Almost, maybe a little bit too pink, neutral, but it does not matter. Oh yeah, am I the only one who is still being eaten alive by mosquitoes? There are so many mosquitoes floating around still. It is just insane. In the summer, I think I was bitten twice or maybe three times the whole of the summer. And now it's almost every evening. It's annoying, but yeah, what can you do about it? Nothing really. So yeah, foundation is on. That was quick. That was very, very nice. I also want concealer. This is going to be the True Skin. I love this concealer as well. I need to do a favorites video soon, I think, because I do really have some favorite products right now. Oh yeah, do you like my nails? These are also from Primark. I thought, you know what, let me just buy, these are not press-on nails, these are glue-on nails, but they are, can you see how they are called? Squareletto Matte in Plum. And they are pretty long, and I actually got another one, the Coffin Glossy, and I thought these were very, very pretty, but these are very, very long for me. So if I hold my finger next to one, you can kind of see, so I think I need to cut these a little bit shorter. I do really love the color though. And I kind of like them. They were, what were they? 150 in euro, something along those lines. It's insane. Very, very nice. So yeah. Okay, that is done. Base is looking Very, very pretty. Let me also whack on my Fenty stick. Let me put on a bronzer and a blush and then I will be back. And I will kind of tell a little bit more of the tale of how this happened. Yes, because I kind of need to maybe cry a little bit in the corner as well. Okay, base is on. Let's try the eye primer. Let's get the brushes. Yes. No. Yes, thank you. And just swirl it in. Swirl a brush in. I cannot even speak anymore. A little bit more, maybe. Let's see. It is a little bit colder here in the room, so maybe that is it. It doesn't feel as dry as the MAC Paint Pot, I think. Okay, let me see close. Okay, yeah, it looks okay. So I'm actually very curious to see how shadows will perform on top of it. I have decided I want to use the red shimmer today. And I think I'm going to do basically a red smoky eye with orange around it. That was a little bit of the idea. So I am going to start with the orange, and I'm going to start with the shade called, I think I'm going to start with the shade Off. So let me put on some eyeshadow while I tell the tale of what happened, or at least try to stay on topic, which is usually kind of a problem for me. So yeah, it all, my tale basically starts 2 weeks ago when I decided to bleach the hair again, and I always do it myself. I have been doing my own hair coloring for years and usually it all goes very, very well. So yeah, I bleached my hair the first time and it felt a little bit dry, but overall it was kind of okay. Usually I have specific shampoos and toners as well to make sure that it is not yellow but goes more towards the gray side of things. So I had bleached my hair the day after I had toned it, so to make sure that it was more gray and not as yellow. Now, unfortunately, the toner that I usually use, the color corrector, it's always out of stock here where I get my stuff. So that was kind of unfortunate, but I got there in the end anyway. So that was all good. Then a few days later, I shaved my hair in. Basically, I gave myself a haircut to make it look like it was nice and not grown, a buzz cut grown out over a few months. You know, that was what I did, and it looked cute actually. That was what happened when you saw the video that went online Monday the 9th. That was the way that it looked then, and it looked very, very nice. The downside is, though, when I have my silver hair, is that the sides here turn yellow very, very quickly because of the makeup that I wear. And I do make sure that it is clean. But usually, that is actually what I remember now. Usually when I had my silver hair, I cleaned it with basically a cloth like this, a microfiber cloth and water. Now I use micellar water, and I did kind of wipe off the micellar water again, but maybe that is the reason that it dried out a little bit quicker here at the sides. Remember that dried out part at the sides, because it's important later on. So yeah, unfortunately it turned a little bit yellow again, and I was like, okay, you know what, let's put in a special dye that I had bought to get my hair gray. So I did that, and it was nice, but a little bit too dark. And what happens when my hair is too dark of a gray? I don't know, I feel old. And that's maybe weird, but it's not the color that I was going for. And I don't mind gray hair at all. I am going gray, I don't care. But there is a specific kind of gray, basically this kind of gray, that kind of makes me, when my hair is that short, it just makes me look 60, guys. It's just the way that I feel, at least. it's not pretty. I'm going to go to the brightest red called the. So, yeah, I had that for a few days and I was like, you know what? I kind of wanted it a little bit lighter. So, I thought if I use the dye from that, you know, the actual dye, and then bleach my hair for, I don't know, half an hour or 40 minutes, you know, it should kind of counteract the fact that it is so dark without turning it yellow. That was the plan. So, let's get a clean brush. So yeah, I just put in the dye and let it sit for about 40 minutes or something. Then I rinsed it out, put in a hair mask specifically for colored hair. So yeah, I kind of went about my business. I was editing the video and I was uploading a video and all that. Then I went to rinse that out and put in a specific, it's kind of a shampoo-y toner. That's what I put in then. And I let that sit for just a second, or at least I thought it was just a second. And then I went into the room here. I kind of rearranged stuff. Suffice to say about, I don't know, I think it was an hour later that I went into the shower and I saw that the toner had done its work. It wasn't yellow, it was kind of purpley, lavendery, which is kind of what I want usually, because then I know that it is not yellow anymore and that when I rinse it out, it is all good again. So I rinsed out my hair, looked in the mirror, and saw that it was still, I don't know, it was looking patchy. Now, you have to remember that I'm in the shower. It's warm. We have a mirror there, but it kind of fogs over a little bit as well. So I wiped it clean-ish. And I looked and I was like, it's a little bit patchy here and there. But usually when I then go wash my hair with shampoo, it kind of evens out. So I did that. And then I looked again and I saw that I had a very purpley patch here, and here, and then there. And the rest was a little bit yellow. And I was like, what happened? So I turned off the shower, cleaned the mirror well, and I looked and I was like, it's not supposed to be like that, is it? So I kind of dried my hair a little bit and then I looked at the towel and I saw that there were hairs stuck on the towel. So I looked again. What had happened? I think you can guess. My hair had broken off, but not evenly. No. Patchily. So I had basically very, very short yellow hair, which, yeah, it was still yellow. I had that here on the sides. And then here as well. And at the back, I could not see the back, but basically here. And then here I had longer hairs, which were purple. And I had tufts of hair here that were purple. Yeah. So that is what happened. Then I yelled downstairs for someone to bring up the hair clippers. And then this happened. And that is basically the tale of how I went from my silvery foxiness to my auntie festeriness. And that all happened yesterday, the 9th, when the video went online with my very nice silver hair. That was the idea, you know, for at least a few months. And I had a lot of trouble not answering you guys when you said that you love my silver hair. Because I was like, yeah, but it's not silver anymore, it's this. But I wanted to make a video telling the tale, so I kept my mouth shut. But that's basically what happened yesterday. And then my son came home and asked if I had shaved my eyebrows. So, yeah. So the moral of the story is, don't do what I did. But when I went to shave it, I tried to dry it off a little bit more. I could see tufts of lavender here and there. And that part where almost nothing was shaved off. And I was like, oh Lord. Now I know that I've had it like this a lot of the time, but it was not supposed to be that. It was supposed to be a silver vixen. That was the plan. But yeah, I should have just known better, because plans never really, yeah. So I'm on Tivester again. And yesterday, that was also the weird thing. Usually when I really shave my hair, it's my own color. And my own color is basically, yeah, it's dark brown. And you can kind of see it peeking through now. But yesterday when I shaved it, it was almost as if I had no hair. Not that that is a problem, because I have shaved my hair, my head in the summer. But yeah, then also with the fact that I thought it was a good idea to kind of bleach my eyebrows, I just looked like, yeah, well, basically how I started the video. So yeah, that was what happened at the end of my vacation. What did I do in my vacation? Because probably some of you are wondering. I know that I got asked the question. I read books. I love to read, and I actually read a lot back in the day, but there isn't a lot of time, or that's not really true. I don't give myself a lot of time to read a book. A friend of mine wrote, is a writer, and I shared it on my Instagram, her books. I have two of her books, and she's working on number three now. And it is basically a tale of reincarnation. It's a reincarnation story and a story of a two-spirit, and how basically her journey finding out that she was a two-spirit, and how that whole journey went. And it is romanticized, so there's also a little bit of fiction involved, but largely it's her tale, or it's their tale, actually. And her second book has been out for quite some time. I will link them down below. They are in Dutch though. They're just in Dutch. So I don't know if she will ever come out with this tale in English. I kind of think she should, but yeah, who am I to tell them what to do? I think it's a good idea though, if she were able to kind of have them in English as well. I know I will see her soon, or see them soon, with my bestie. So yeah, I want, by the way, the shadows performed very, very nicely on top of the base. No problems whatsoever, no patchiness. The blending went very, very well, so I'm happy about that. I want the red shimmer. Oh yeah, I was talking about what I was doing in my vacation. Well, basically reading and reorganizing. You know, it all started with a stain on the inside of my kitchen cabinet. I wanted to clean that stain, and basically I after that deep cleaned the kitchen. Oh, this is so pretty. Deep cleaned the kitchen, rearranged stuff in the cupboards, in the kitchen, and then my house is pretty small. My desk was usually under or against the window, and now it is against the side, so I have the window here, and then my desk is like that, and then the kitchen is to the side there. So yeah, that's what happened as well. I cleaned my windows. I don't, if you know me, you know I don't, I'm going to go back to the black again, you know that I don't clean my windows often, because I detest when I have done my windows and I have stripes. I cannot stand stripes on my window, so I usually let them get very, very dirty, so then I don't notice the stripes anymore, you know. However, I did use a different dishwashing soap to do my windows, and I don't really have any stripes now, so that is very nice. So yeah, I do have a little bit of fallout, but that's okay. I also want that shade underneath my eye, because it's just gorgeous. I'm going to spray it. So yeah, and then basically I think the consensus from there was that I should not go as a silver vixen. I should just go as Auntie Vester. So that is then what happened. Oh, I love this. I love this. Let me quickly do that here too. And then while I think about inner corner highlight, maybe the silver. I think that's going to be yeah, it's probably going to be the silver in the palette to kind of remember my silver hair that I had to shave off yesterday. Lord, I can still see the tufts. I'm just very grateful that I don't mind this hairstyle, you know? It wasn't, as I said, not the plan. But can you imagine that happening if you have very, very gorgeously long hair and then having to shave it off because you made a boo-boo with bleaching? Oh yes, and the silver inner corner. Yes, let me grab the silver. Lord, do I not know how to put on eyeshadow anymore? Okay, on the bigger brush, one side a little bit of the silver, other side a little bit of the red. Let's see if I can kind of mix them a little bit. Something like that. Yes, me likey. Okay, let me put on liner.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
Okay, I put on liner and mascara. Now let's see if I have falsies. These are very... Do I want dramatic? I kind of do. But I have these are Shelby. Very dramatic. Or dramatic. They are nice and... Yeah, dramatic. Yeah. Then I have the Amandas, which are a little bit more natural. Can you... Yes, a little bit more natural and a little bit spiky. But I also have the Noras, which are these, which are also a little bit spiky, but a little bit less spiky. Maybe I need to do them like this. Can you see? So they do look quite similar. But the Amandas are a little bit more, I don't know, these are a little bit more open, the Noras. And then I also have the Jean and the Carlene. And the Jean are a little bit like the Shelby, but a little bit more 3D almost. So here you have those two styles. Yes, and then the last one are the Carlenes, which are a little bit more, they're not as flared. They are the same thingamajingy all around. So now I kind of need to think, I kind of want to try the Shelbys, these. Yes, let's do the Shelbys. Let's do those. And I have a bunch of them. Okay, I'm foaming. Yeah, AOA Studio, the charity edition. These were $1.55. Very curious about these. Let me cut them to length and put them on. I thought, let's just embrace the anti-fester part of everything. The lip is from VE Cosmetics. It's the shade Black Hole. It's the only black that I have. And this is a liquid moisture lipstick, which is, when you put it on, almost like a vinyl, and then it dries down. I think it's very, very comfortable. I did order, I think she also had kind of a brownie one that I did order that I'm still waiting on. So I hope that it will arrive soon. So yeah, let's kind of go over everything that I used that was new. That was basically, where did I put the primer? Wow. Underneath the little towel. The primer, yeah, it feels nice. Perfect filter face primer. I don't know. Does it need to then blur? I don't think it really did. But it does feel nice. So yeah, that's all I can say. I will keep on using it. I don't know what they compared this one to though. But I do know that a lot of people really like this primer. So yeah, right now that the weather is kind of turning a little bit colder, I prefer a primer with a little bit more substance to it. Like for instance this one. What other primer was I using? Oh yeah, the Angel Veil. I think I actually like this one more. Just feeling how it feels on my skin. But yeah, I will keep on using it. I will link it down below. Then we have the eye base. Yeah, it's nice. It does not feel overly heavy. It did not feel very dry. I feel like I can nicely build it up as well. It does remind me a little bit of the Paint Pot. But then way cheaper. Cruelty free. And less. I think that the color is also almost the same. Yeah, I will keep on playing with it. So far, I like it. If you have it, let me know how you like it though. I think they had more colors, but I'm not sure. I will link that one down below as well. Then let's go to the falsies. I have the style Shelby on now. The band is thicker, but it is very lightweight. I have some foamings from Ali. At least that's what they said they were foaming. That's what they said in the advert. They are, the band is stiffer. It's maybe a little bit, especially the first time that you put on falsies with a thicker band, they can be a bit uncomfortable. These are not though. These feel lightweight. The only thing though is the application here was a little bit wonky. This one feels wonky because I left it a little bit too long. So yeah, this one sits perfectly. I don't feel it at all. I do feel this one, but that is because of the application. I just need to cut off maybe 2 millimeters at the end part, and then it will be okay. I just checked. Unfortunately, I only got one of these. So yeah, I do think they're very, very pretty. And even though I got the style London again from Primark, they did not have the style, what was it, the other ones that I have. I think though, just on first application, I will really, really like these. And I think I need more of these. Just because of how they look, how they applied, at least that eye. I love how the look turned out. I, as you see, put on a sweater. Maybe I need to change up my ear plugs as well, but I don't really feel like it right now. That is it for today. I hope that I enjoyed you with my story time. I hope I kind of made a story time. I feel like I'm not really well versed in that. Usually because my mind goes everywhere, and now I kind of knew how I wanted to tell the tale of, yeah, me basically losing my hair again. Not really voluntarily, but yeah, let me know if it was helpful, if it was entertaining. And yeah, then that is going to be it for today's video. I'm going to go to the site to give a special thank you to the members that you will see scrolling on the screen. If you want to become a member and be part of my nest, you can click the link in the description box. That was basically what I wanted to say. Yeah, that's going to be it. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button before you leave, because I would love to have you. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.